Hey there, viewers. Heading to the beach? Well, summer vacations are indeed all about sea, sun, and sunscreen. If you're a beach bum like me, sunscreen is a staple for you. Unfortunately, there's a lot of confusion surrounding it. In today's video, we'll be busting some of these myths to separate fact from fiction. Do they prevent your body from absorbing vitamin D? Can you skip them on a cloudy day? Can tanning beds replace the need for good sunscreen? We'll be talking all this and more. Number 1. Tanning beds are as good as sunscreen. There's a misconception that all you need is a quick tan right at the start of summer. After that, you can enjoy the beach life without worrying about protecting your skin from the sun. False. A temporary tan can't protect your skin from sun exposure or the risks of sunburn. Before we bust this myth, we need to understand the concept of UVA and UVB light. Both are types of ultraviolet rays. UVA is a longer wave and will penetrate even the thickest layer of skin. It's the unprotected UVA exposure that gives you wrinkles, a suppressed immune system, and other signs of skin aging. UVB rays are shorter and responsible for giving you a sunburn that's burning the top layer of skin. Frequent sunburns caused irreversible damage to your skin. UVB rays are to blame for skin cancer. Coming back to the point, why did we even touch on the concept of UVA and UVB? Because the beautiful tan you rock comes from protected exposure to high concentrations of UVA light. Tanning beds use this to darken your skin quickly. Since sunlight contains both UVA and UVB light, a temporary tan is basically ineffective in protecting your skin from the harmful effects caused by UVB. This is why tanning beds can't replace your sunscreen. Number 2. Only people with lighter skin need sunscreen. Nope, that's a big fat lie. It doesn't matter what your skin tone is. You're still at risk if you go out without applying sunscreen. Actually, this myth originates from the fact that melanin pigment, responsible for making your skin dark, protects you from sunburns. But this is because melanin diffuses UVB light. So you might be protected against sunburns, but are still at risk for other damages caused by UVA light. You need to apply a full spectrum sunscreen. Melanin won't save you from the harmful effects of UVA. Melanin also doesn't protect you against skin cancer caused by extreme sun exposure. A study found that skin cancer survival rates among people with darker skin were lower. Are you finding this list useful so far? Well, the next point is surely to surprise you. But before we continue, why not subscribe to our channel for more videos like this and hit the bell icon so you're always up to date. Number 3. Sunscreen won't give your body enough vitamin D. Vitamin D is very important for your body, especially if you want stronger bones and joints. Your body makes this vital nutrient easily when exposed to UV rays in the sunlight. So if you apply sunscreen that protects you from UVA and UVB rays, will it prevent your body from making vitamin D? In theory, it might sound possible since sunscreen blocks UV rays, but no. There are various reasons. First of all, sunlight penetrates through your clothes as well, so it's not like you shield 100% of your body from the sun. Next, even if you're an uber-conscious person who keeps sunscreen around, it's difficult to be alert all the time. There will be times you forget to apply a sunscreen, or might apply too little quantity. Sunscreen also loses effectiveness over time. If you applied sunscreen in the morning, you'll be back to square one by the afternoon. You need to apply a good amount of sunscreen every 1 or 2 hours to be absolutely safe. 5 to 30 minutes of sun exposure is enough for your body to make vitamin D. Number 4. You don't need sunscreen on cloudy days. Oh, you absolutely do. This is one of the most common misconceptions. If you think going out on a cloudy day means there are no harsh sun rays, you would be making your skin all the more vulnerable to sun damage. You can't skip out on sunscreen because the clouds aren't blocking the sun's rays. In fact, clouds provide you a false sense of security. About 40% of UV rays are still reaching us through the clouds. By stepping out without applying sunscreen, you're exposing your skin to harmful UV rays that can give you a sunburn and cause premature signs of aging. Before we move ahead, here's a video you might like. Want to take extra care of your skin and eat foods that boost collagen production? Here's a video on 9 best collagen-boosting foods. Number 5. Your makeup can replace sunscreen. Makeup products these days do provide a little sun protection, but they can't replace a heavy-duty sunscreen. You need high SPF to protect your skin from the effects of UV light. Makeup is too little and just an additional layer of protection. You can't rely solely on this. Number 6. You won't tan when you wear sunscreen. This is another very popular misconception. A lot of people think that by applying sunscreen, they can protect their skin from tanning as well. Sunscreen will protect your skin from the damaging effects of UVA and UVB, but no protection is 100% effective. You might tan even after applying sunscreen several times throughout the day. If you don't like tanned skin, apply sunscreen and make sure to cover your exposed skin with a hat, scarf, and clothing. Number 7. One application of sunscreen will last you all day. Going to the beach? It's great that you applied a decent amount of sunscreen, but do you think it'll protect your skin all day long? No! When you're out in public places, you are constantly exposed to the sun. You can't depend on your sunscreen to protect you the entire day. You need to reapply sunscreen every 1 to 2 hours. Otherwise, your skin's on its own. If you're headed out to the beach or outdoor swimming pools, your waterproof sunscreen will be of no use. You must apply sunscreen immediately before and after swimming. No matter how good your sunscreen is, water will wash it away. The same goes for sweating. Your sunscreen might say it's sweatproof, yet a lot of it gets washed away after you wipe it off. So how do you ensure that you're applying your sunscreen with the proper intervals? Set up a timer to remind you every 2 hours to apply sunscreen. In case you're at the beach for a relaxing day, apply it every hour. Every time you wipe your face or body, slather sunscreen again. Number 8. All sunscreens are the same. Nope, not even close. They have different ingredients and provide different levels of protection. Some sunscreen contain chemical blockers, like avobenzone. Then there are sunscreens with active ingredients like zinc oxide and titanium dioxide to block rays. Sunscreens have different sun protection factors, SPF as well. For instance, ones with SPF 15 will protect you against 95% of UVB rays, while SPF 30 sunscreens shield you from 98% of them. Number 9. Sunscreens do not expire. Wrong. The active ingredient in sunscreen breaks down over time. This is why sunscreens have an expiry date, and when you use them past their best used before date, you're basically leaving your skin unprotected. This is because all of the ingredients blocking and shielding you are no longer of use. In short, it's as good as applying nothing on your skin. Did you buy into any of these myths before watching this video? Do you apply sunscreen regularly? Let us know in the comment section below. We'd love to hear from you.
Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait! What kind of Bestie would we be if we didn't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or right video and enjoy.